Hello, and welcome back to the kitchen for another rendition of me trying to cook things. I know it's been a while, but with the whole coronavirus thing, I didn't think it was a good idea to waste food trying to learn how to cook when the grocery stores were already low on supplies, but now that things are kind of getting back to normal, it seems like a good time to continue. Last time we did some breakfast with some pancakes, this time we're jumping over to dinner with some beer-battered fish and chips.
Light and crispy beer-battered cod with delicious thick-cut chips has become an iconic and quintessential British dish. Tracer has traveled all over the world and across time, but fish and chips has always been her favorite dish no matter where she's been. She's got this particular recipe from the chippy just outside King's Row called Bell Fish and Chips. For this recipe, you'll need 2 cups all-purpose flour, 1 tablespoon of baking powder, 1 teaspoon salt, 1/4 teaspoon of cayenne pepper, 1 12-ounce bottle of brown ale or amber beer, I have this Guinness stout here, 1.5 pounds firm-fleshed whitefish cut into 1-inch strips like this codfish here, cornstarch for dredging, and 2 to 4 cups of vegetable oil. In a medium-sized mixing bowl, combine the dry ingredients, and then whisk the beer in until the batter is smooth. Let sit for about 20 minutes, fill a small bowl with cornstarch and set aside.
I have severely underestimated the size of this bowl.
Heat the oil to around 350 degrees in a frying pan with tall sides, line a plate with paper towels and set aside. Dip the strips of fish into the cornstarch, then into the batter. Working with only a couple pieces at a time, lower the battered fish into hot oil. Cook on both sides about 2 minutes in total until crispy and golden brown. Remove the strips and lay them on a paper towel lined plate to drain. Repeat until all the strips are fried. Serve with fries, malt vinegar, and a good amount of salt.
Well, after having some of the fish, I can easily say that this is a good fish and chips recipe. The fish is nice and well cooked, and the batter has that nice pub style taste to it. The batter was a little bit on the chewy side of things, and that's probably on me for not cooking it long enough. I just kind of cooked it until it was golden brown. I didn't really time it out like the cookbook said to do. Also, the cayenne pepper flavor wasn't really there. You don't really taste the spice of the cayenne pepper with it being, you know, just a small amount scattered around 4 different servings, or in my case, 8 pieces of fish. So if you want it a little spicier, you might want to add more cayenne pepper. The recipe's open to some customization. If you'd also like to do that, you can add new spices or different spices to give it a different flavor. You can also do different beers. I went with the Guinness, but you could try, you know, something like a Yingling or, you know, just cheap Budweiser or something like that. Just make it your own and you should be good to go. The batter was a bit on the thick and sticky side, as you probably saw me trying to make it. It will just stick to your hands, it will stick to everything. So prepare for a messy time in making it. I'd recommend trying to do like a wet hand, dry hand technique, which I kind of switched to a little bit into cooking the recipe. But overall, if you want a good fish and chips recipe at home, then this is it. And that was how you make Tracer's Beer Battered Fish and Chips, a good at-home fish and chips recipe that is easy to make, but requires a little bit of cleanup afterwards. Thanks for watching, and be sure to come back for some more of these cooking videos. Hopefully the next one won't take 7 months to make. We'll see.